When you have something, it's possible to take it for granted. For those who don't, they feel like something is missing. It limits you and sets you back in life. So, let's talk about hearing loss. In the UK alone, it's estimated 750,000 people are living with severe to profound hearing loss. According to the World Health Organization, there are approximately 72 million people around the world who could potentially benefit from the use of a hearing device such as cochlear implant or hearing aid. So when I was invited by Cochlear to see what they're doing to help and change the lives of those living with hearing loss, I jumped at the opportunity to speak to various people in order to understand more and help spread the word.
We know worldwide there's 466 million people living with a disabling hearing loss, which is a phenomenal number when you think about it. So in the UK we know that there's at least 750,000 people living with disabling hearing loss. People are willing to move forward with technology to improve their improve the intervention, the hearing, and basically the connectivity with life. And that's exactly what a lot of these recipients want to do. They want to re-engage with life, and it's so important because the number of patients I've met in the past who have as their hearing loss has declined over the years, they move away from difficult situations and family environments, and it's very important sort of with implantable hearing solutions that we can give them that connectivity back into engaging, because living with disabling hearing loss can lead to social isolation, early onset dementia, and it's well documented. And I think actually we've got an educational piece to do with audiologists around the world to make sure that these patients aren't sitting with hearing aids, and a lot of these patients' hearing aids aren't suitable and they need to move into the implantable hearing solutions space, as well as making sure that the public are aware of the technology that's available to them beyond hearing aids.
At this year's CI 2018 conference in Antwerp, Belgium, I got to check out the Nucleus 7 sound processor, the world's smallest and lightest behind-the-ear cochlear implant sound processor. It's also a pioneer as it's the first and only made for iPhone sound processor, meaning Cochlear worked with Apple to have it baked into iOS when you download the Nucleus Smart app. Before I go further, I spoke to Keith about what the device actually is.
So a cochlear implant system is made up of two basic parts. Firstly, we have the implant, and then we have the sound processor, which is worn outside of the body. The sound processor's role is to provide power and, more importantly, sound from the external environment to the implant. The sound processor is made up of three basic parts. We have the sound processor itself, which picks up sound via our dual microphone technology and compresses the sound, and using DSP, it sends it via the coil to the implant. We also have a battery, a lithium-ion battery, and also zinc air battery, which powers the sound processor. With Nucleus 7, we are very excited to deliver also a USB charger to make charging of the lithium-ion battery much more convenient for our recipients. The USB charger is available in two different types. Firstly, a Y charger, which allows a recipient to charge two batteries simultaneously, and also a single USB charger.
The Nucleus Smart app allows the user to be in control of their sound processor. In fact, it gives people with hearing loss more control over their hearing than someone with regular hearing. It comes with some amazing yet simple to use features called Hearing Tracker, Find My Processor, and the ability to switch off background sound or hear from the next room. Adam from Cochlear showed me the app, which allows the user to stream from various audio sources straight to their sound processor, whether they use an iPhone or an Android device.
The N7 is the first made for iPhone cochlear implant, which is a huge deal because there have been hearing aids that have done that, but never been a cochlear implant that's done that. And so our sound processor can stream directly from audio that is playing on your phone, that can stream directly to your sound processor.
So what we have here is the smart app for the N7, and we've got it running on both iOS and Android. And so the new announcement today is that we're on Android. So what the app does is it replaces the need to have this physical remote control that we used to have, which is like the size of an iPod Nano kind of thing that you'd have to carry around with you and make all your adjustments. Now that we've got, you know, Bluetooth low energy on the sound processor, we can talk directly to your phone, and you can come in and do all your simple changes. Like you can come in and see the volume level that you're at, you can make adjustments to the volume, you can change your audio sources, So we have, for instance, a TV streamer and a mini mic, which are little accessories that we sell, say, to plug it into a TV, and then you get your sound streamed directly from the TV to your sound processor. So you can come into the app, and the app is your remote control for all of that kind of stuff that you want to do. At the top right, we show you your processor status, so your battery and your processor status. You can tap that, and you come in and see the status screen, where we give you, at a glance, all the information that you're interested in. So your battery level, the health of the sound processor, whether or not, you know, like the coil is off, or whether you need to, you know, replace a particular part or anything like that. And we also give you a sound level meter so that you can see what the mics are actually picking up around you. Other cool stuff that we have a Find My Sound Processor feature, which is effectively like Find My iPhone, but for your sound processor. We can come in and we can see on a map where your sound processor is and where it was last seen, for instance, if it was disconnected, so you can go and find it, you know, it's at school or it's at home or something like that. We also support a nearby mode, which is where we're using the Bluetooth signal strength to work out how far away the sound processor is. So if you're in the room, but you know it's behind the couch or you're not really sure where it is, you can walk around the room using this level that goes up and down and use that to help you try to find where your sound processor is. Also, we have this functionality called Hearing Tracker, which is really cool. It's kind of like Fitbit, but for your hearing. So with the CI, it tracks how long you're in a speech environment. And what we do is the app grabs that data from the sound processor and can show you that, you know, for instance, yesterday you were in a speech environment for 2 hours, and your clinician might say, look, you need to set 3 hours as your minimum target every day. And the app gives you nice graphs, historical data, so you can come in and see how you're tracking against your goals that your clinician has given you.
This year, Cochlear also announced an exciting new feature that will give Nucleus 7 users superhuman-like abilities. The forward focus feature allows the user to change focus to the sound in front of them. Imagine having a meeting or having dinner with friends and family, and you can focus the two built-in microphones to focus on the person speaking to you and block out the background noise or sound coming from behind you if it's too distracting or making it difficult.
I have a client who is a psychologist, and she sees clients on a regular basis, and the clients bring their children into the office. And when they do that, the children are playing and playing with blocks and talking. And for my client to then focus on her session with her client, she just turns on forward focus and it literally blocks out all of the noise behind her. So it's important for the recipients to put themselves in the right scenario where they've got their backs to the noise, and it really cancels out everything like that. We have so many of our recipients who've said to us, I can't go to the pub anymore if I don't have my forward focus, because it's just too noisy if I can't enable forward focus while I'm, you know, having a good time and in a social scenario with lots of noise around.
To further understand how it's being used, I got the opportunity to speak with two people who wear a Nucleus 7 sound processor: Roger Smith, Cochlear's Global Product Manager, and Angela Irwin.
Our ability to create a processor that was made for iPhone was a huge advance in technology, but it was also a game changer for our customers. So we have lots of customers who comment to us that hearing on the phone is very challenging. So we knew that making a processor made for iPhone was going to deliver on that challenge. And made for iPhone does two things for our customers. It means that they can stream audio directly from the phone to their processor. So if you think about everything that people do with their phone these days, they're talking on the phone, but also listening to music, watching videos, using apps and games, and all of that streams, all of that uses audio. And in the past, it was very hard for people with hearing loss to be able to access that access those features on their phone, because it's hard to hear on the speaker of a phone, or headphones or earbuds are just not practical. So being able to stream sound directly from their phone to their processor is a game changer, and the quality of the sound is unparalleled. It's like the person's talking inside your head. So our customers are saying to us now how life-changing it is to be able to stream from their phone to their processor. So they're able to take job interviews over the phone, which they were afraid to do in the past. And they're able to have conference calls with colleagues in different countries where it was hard to hear them with their accents, and now they can do that because they can stream that sound directly to their processor.
Hi, I'm Angela. I'm a Nucleus cochlear implant recipient.
I'm actually celebrating 21 years with my first cochlear implant this month. And so I wanted to show the original processor that I had, which was this one. It was called the Sprint Body Processor. But you can see the size, how big it is compared to, I now have the Nucleus 7 processors, which are just so small and so light behind the ear. But I used to have to have this clipped on and run the cord up, you know, underneath your shirt, and you would clip it to your collar. So not the funnest thing. I was, you know, in my early 20s when I was first implanted, so wasn't exactly exciting for a 20-year-old to want to wear this, but I would have worn it every day for the rest of my life because of the hearing results that I got with the cochlear implant, being able to use the phone again, being able to be in social situations again. So it was just incredible. So now, fast forward 21 years, I'm on my 7th upgrade. With the Nucleus 7, which is just amazing. I would have never expected that when I was first implanted. Cochlear is just so dedicated to improving the hearing outcomes and the technology for our recipients. It's been really fun to have this latest upgrade, the Nucleus 7, and have it be compatible with my iPhone, so I can control both processors with my iPhone. Can enable forward focus, which has just been really incredible. In noisy situations, the technology was already great in noisy situations, but this is again another step up. And I think now, as a deaf person, I have the advantage in noisy environments over the normal hearing people because the technology is just so amazing.
Besides the innovative forward focus feature, Android and Nucleus 24 implant series compatibility, I started thinking about the future and what's next for Cochlear. Speaking to various people and recipients has really opened my eyes to the world of hearing loss and Cochlear's dedication to innovate and change lives for the better. I can only imagine what's next, such as the use of AI, automatically switching on and off forward focus, or even real-time language translation. If you want to find out more, check out the links in the description, and Cochlear also on social media if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell button to be one of the first people to know every time there's a new video on the channel. See you guys in the next one.